Şöyle yapabilirim. Assalamualaikum. Today is our first lecture of the bone and joint. In this bone and joint, we only discuss the important lesions of the bone and joint. Inshallah. So first of all, we start with the name of Allah. The today lecture, bone and joint. First of all, what is bone? As you know, it is the type of connective tissue. And it is, as you know, it is an important part of our body. It gives shape to the body. It gives strength to the body. So bone is a type of connective tissue that undergoes mineralization. Unmineralized bone is known as osteoid. Bone is composed of two parts, inorganic and organic. Inorganic, it is composed of about 65% of the bone is composed of inorganic component. It gives bone strength and hardness. Its main component is hydroxyapatite. Hydroxyapatite kya hai beta? Hydroxyapatite is the naturally occurring mineralized calcium. And isko kehte hain hydroxyapatite. It also contains inorganic component, also contain magnesium, potassium, chloride, and sodium. So it is the first part of the bone, inorganic component. Second is the organic component. It accounts for 35%. यानी कि ये होता है तकरीबन 35%. It is composed of bone cell and protein of matrix. Its formation is regulated by cytokines and growth factor. Bone protein is collagen type 1, as you know. Now the type of bone cells which are present in bone. Osteoblast, as you know, responsible for production of osteoid. Unmineralized, we call it osteoid. When mineralized, it will become bone. Contain high amount of alkaline phosphate. It has receptor for parathyroid hormone. And average lifespan is 3 months. It either undergoes apoptosis or transform into osteocyte. So the osteoblast remain as cell and then can change into the osteocyte. Osteocyte is most abundant bone forming cell, or osteocyte or to osteoblast ratio is about 10:1. Now it is an osteoblast that has become incorporated in the matrix. It is responsible for cell maintenance. The third cell is osteoclast. It is derived from the hematopoietic progenitor cell. Kaun se hematopoietic progenitor cell? Which also give monocyte macrophage also produce osteoclast, and osteoclast is not a single; it is made up of many cells. So osteoclast is also contain many nuclei in them. It is the differentiating point that osteoclast contain. It is made up of many cells. It arises from the progenitor cell, which also give rise the monocyte macrophage, and it is also made up of many cells. So it contain many nuclei, and the important function of the osteoclast is the bone resorption. Wo bone formate karta hai, ye bone resorption karta hai. It contain high amount of acid phosphatases and collagenases. It resorb bone with how shaped lacunae. Above how shaped lacunae kya hai? What is how shaped lacunae? High shaped lacunae are the small pits, small grooves are present within the bone. And this contain the osteoclast. How shaped lacunae kya hai? Small pits hai, grooves hai, depression hai in the bone which contain osteoclast. So resorption of the bone is start within the how shaped lacunae which contain osteoclast. Now the structural bone types of the bone composition. Number one, as you know, cortical or compact bone. 80% of skeleton is dense outer shell responsible for structural rigidity. Consist of Haversian canal. As you know, in the center there is a tube which contains nerves, blood vessels, blood capillaries, and this is the source of oxygen supply to the bone. Haversian canal, it is a tube which contains nerves and blood vessels, or this is surrounded by the concentric layer of mineralized collagen forming osteons which are joined together by cement lines. अच्छा दिस कॉर्टिकल और कॉम्पैक्ट बोन फॉर्म शाफ्ट और डायफेसेस ऑफ लॉन्ग बोन, यानी कि जो सेंट्रल पार्ट इज मेड अप ऑफ द कॉर्टिकल और कॉम्पैक्ट टाइप ऑफ द बोन. Second variety is the trabecular or cantilus bone. It is composed of 20% of skeleton and has trabeculae traversing the marrow space. This part of the bone, this type of the bone form epiphyses of the long bone. यानी कि जो corners होते हैं, this is formed by the trabecular or cantilus type of the bone. Now here you can see spongy bone is present at the epiphyses. Or also it contain the red bone marrow, yellow bone marrow, and the outer is the periosteum, which is the outer covering is periosteum, and endosteum which cover the medulla. Two part cortex and medulla. Outer है, cortex है, inside medulla है. Cortex को cover किया हुआ है periosteum में, और endosteum cover the medullary cavity. और ये देखिए in the central diaphysis is made up by the this compact bone and epiphyses are made by this trabecular or spongy bone. Now you can see here the difference between the compact and spongy bone. Spongy bone is also called cantilus or trabecular bone. It is found in the long bone and it is found by compact bone, as I have told you. Compact bone also called cortical bone, surrounded spongy bone. They are heavy, tough and compact in nature. Now you can see the microscopically difference between these two. In the right there is the trabecular bone, or in the left you can see the compact bone, which is dense, compact, and here you can see the loose tissue, adipose tissue is present and contain less trabecular network. So this is the difference between the trabecular and compact bone. Now the first topic which we discuss, first lesion which we discuss is the osteoporosis. So what is osteoporosis? Osteoporosis is an acquired condition characterized by reduced bone mass leading to bone fragility and susceptibility to fracture. It is the most important cause of fracture in females. The bone loss may be confined to certain bones or region or be generalized involving the entire skeleton. Sometimes this osteoporosis involves a part of the bone, sometimes they involve a region of the bone, and sometimes they involve whole of the skeleton. Generalized osteoporosis may be primary or occur secondary to variety of conditions. There is a list of conditions which lead to the osteoporosis, which is not mentioned in the lecture, but you can see in your books, there's a list of conditions which lead to the osteoporosis. In which the most important, as you know, the senile osteoporosis and the postmenopausal osteoporosis. Then it also secondary to the endocrine condition, hyperparathyroidism, hypothyroidism, and the gastrointestinal condition, malabsorption, and variety or the drugs. Certain drugs can lead to the osteoporosis. So the list of the conditions are there which lead to the osteoporosis. Now the primary, most common and may be associated with aging or the postmenopausal state in women. Or kya hota hai? Drop in estrogen following menopause tend to exacerbate the loss of bone that occur with aging, placing older women at high risk of osteoporosis relative to men. So females are more prone to fracture postmenopausally as compared to the men. Men mein chances hai aging ki wajah se, lekin less chances hai as compared to the female. Risk of osteoporosis with aging is related to peak bone mass, which is influenced by genetic, nutritional and environmental factors. So it is written peak bone mass. So what is peak bone mass? Peak bone mass is the amount of bone in skeleton, amount of bone tissue in skeleton. And these achieve mostly at the age of late 20s. So peak bone mass is very much important in case of osteoporosis. Jitna greater peak bone mass hoga, the chances of osteoporosis jo hai, wo bahut कम होंगे, लेस होंगे, जैसा कि ग्रेटर होगा पीक बोन मास. peak mass during young adulthood, the greater the peak bone mass, the greater the delay in onset of osteoporosis. There is beginning of increased bone resorption as compared to bone formation occur in men and women during third or fourth decade of life. 20 तक सही रहता है. After 23rd or 4th decade of life में bone formation, bone resorption से कम हो जाएगी. Bone resorption जो है increase as compared to the bone formation. Now you can see bone loss averaging 0.5% per year is consequence of aging and is mostly seen in areas where abundant trabecular bone are present like spine and femoral. So the chances of osteoporosis or the decreased bone mass is mostly in the where the trabecular bone is present as compared to the compact bone. The amount of bone loss with each cycle of remodeling is accelerated after menopause. Progressive loss of bone mass is increased and increased risk of fracture. Each cycle mein jo remodeling hoti hai wo phir jo hai wo kam ho jayegi. In each cycle of remodeling the amount of bone loss is increased as compared to the remodeling after the menopause, and this lead to the fractures. Morphology, hallmarks of osteoporosis is loss of bone, as I told you. Cortices, yani cortex are thin with dilated Haversian canal. Haversian canal, as I have told you, Haversian canal is the central tube. So cortex become thin and Haversian canal become dilated. Trabeculae are reduced in thickness and lost their interconnection. Osteoclastic activity is present. Mineral content of bone is normal. In postmenopausal osteoporosis, trabecular bone loss is severe, resulting in compression fracture and collapse of vertebral body. As I have told you, mostly it occur in the spine. So vertebral body is the compression, or jo vertebral disc ho jayegi wo narrow ho jayenge, aur fir fractures ke chances in the spine or jo hai it is increases. In senile osteoporosis, cortical bone loss is prominent. Postmenopausal mein trabecular or senile osteoporosis mein cortical bone loss jo hai wo prominent hota hai. Now here you can see the osteoporosis. Normal bone density dekhi beta. Compare karein to comparison between the normal bone density and osteoporosis bone density. Here you can see the mineral jo hai uske jo hai wo loss ho gaya hai in osteoporosis as compared to the normal bones in osteoporosis. Pathogenesis, osteoporosis occur when dynamic balance between bone formation by osteoblast and bone resorption by osteoclast still in favor of resorption. So kya hota hai, most of the time osteoclast activity increase ho jati hai as compared to the osteoblast activity. Remodeling jo hai with the bone ki remodeling jo hai wo decrease ho jati hai aur resorption jo hai wo increase ho jati hai. Ab kya hota hai, in age related changes with increasing age, the replicative and matrix production activities of osteoblast progressively diminish. Various growth factors deposited in extracellular matrix also diminish with time. Osteoclasts retain their useful vital. So yahan par kya, osteoblasts, growth factors, growth matrix, jitni bhi protein wagaira wo decrease ho jati hai, lekin osteoclasts jo hai wo bilkul youthful hote hain vital, aur usko the increase their ability or their increase chances of osteoclast. Osteoclast function have increased rahte hain as compared to the osteoblast activity. Ab hormonal influence, decline in estrogen level associated with menopause correlate with an acceleration of cortical and trabecular bone loss. Dono bone loss honge zyada, lekin trabecular hota hai. Over 30 to 40 years loss up to 35% of cortical bone and 50% of trabecular bone. As I have told you, trabecular bone ka loss zyada hota hai in postmenopause as compared to the aging. Half of the postmenopausal women will suffer as osteoporotic fracture compared with 2 to 3% of men of comparable age. So agar female mein because of the menopause due to the hormonal decline, the chances of this osteoporosis is more as compared to the male at the same age. Drop in estrogen level increase cytokine production, interleukin 1, interleukin 6, and tumor necrotic factor from cell in the bone. These stimulate RANK ligand activity and suppress OPG production. What is RANK ligand? RANK is the receptor of the RANK ligand, and this is the this is the some type of the genetic factors which is responsible for osteoclast differentiation and activation, rank ligand. So rank ligand जो है वो उसकी activity increase हो जाती है, यानी कि osteoclast activity increase हो जाती है, and OPD is responsible for osteoclast. This activity is reduced. Rank ligand जो है वो increase the osteoclast differentiation and activation, and OPD production which is responsible for osteoblast is reduced. There is some osteoblast activity. ये नहीं है कि बिल्कुल ही बिल्कुल all lost हो जाए. Some activity of osteoblastic activity is present, but it's inadequate as compared to the osteoclastic bone resorption. Compare करें तो osteoblastic activity कम हो जाती है as compared to the osteoclastic bone resorption. Physical activity, mechanical forces stimulate bone remodeling, reduce physical activity, increase bone loss. This is obvious in an immobilized patient. जो patient बिल्कुल bedridden होते हैं, immobilized होते हैं, फिजिकल एक्टिविटी नहीं होती है, वहां पर जो है ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस के बोन लॉस के चांसेस ज्यादा होते हैं एज कंपेयर टू द मोबिलाइज्ड पर्सन थ्रू आउट स्केलेटन इन एस्ट्रोनॉट्स वर्किंग इन अ ग्रेविटी फ्री एनवायरनमेंट. तो ये वाला जो हम फीचर है वो हम देख सकते हैं एस्ट्रोनॉट्स में जो कि ग्रेविटी फ्री एनवायरनमेंट में फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ द टाइम रहते हैं. Decrease physical activity in older person also lead to the senile osteoporosis. As you know, in old age, physical activity is reduced. So, other cause of senile osteoporosis is the decreased physical activity. Resistance exercise such as weight training exercise bone mass more effectively than endurance activities such as jogging. So, जो exercise जिसमें weight lifting है या weight को करना है तो वो एक्सरसाइजेस ज्यादा बोन को प्रोटेक्ट करती है एज कम्पेयर टू द सिंपल एक्सरसाइजेस विदाउट एनी वेट बियरिंग एक्सरसाइजेस. सो देयर इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द वेट बियरिंग एक्सरसाइजेस एंड द सिंपल एक्सरसाइजेस. रेजिस्टेंस एक्सरसाइजेस आर लीड टू द मोर प्रोडक्शन टू द बोन एज कम्पेयर टू द सिंपल एक्सरसाइजेस विदाउट एनी वेट बियरिंग फैक्टर. Now the genetic factor, vitamin D receptor polymorphism influences the peak bone mass early in life. Polymorphism means the receptor have the different vitamin D receptor have receptor is present there, but their genetic code, their genetic DNA sequence is different. So it show polymorphism. So this receptor is not working properly. Genetic factor also influence calcium uptake or parathyroid synthesis and responses. Genetic factor जो है एज यू नो द पैराथायराइड हार्मोन इज रिस्पॉन्ड टू द लो कैल्शियम लेवल. सो व्हेन द लो कैल्शियम लेवल पैराथायराइड हार्मोन बिकम एक्टिवेट एंड कॉजेज द इंक्रीज एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ कैल्शियम फ्रॉम द इंटेस्टाइन एंड ऑल्सो टू मेंटेन द कैल्शियम लेवल. सो दीज जेनेटिक फैक्टर समटाइम लीड टू द ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस. कैल्शियम न्यूट्रिशन स्टेट. A majority of adolescent girls have insufficient dietary calcium. This calcium deficiency occurs during period of rapid bone growth. So girls do not achieve peak bone mass and likely to develop osteoporosis and at an early age. So it is very much necessary to give a good amount of calcium up to the age of the 20. After 20, you can take, but it is mostly needed during the up to the age of the 20. It is written in the books that up to the 20, you take bone as a bank and you can deposit in this bank, and after 20, you can take from it. So up to the 20, it is very much necessary to give a good amount of calcium to all the girls. You can give both, but it is very much necessary to give a good amount of calcium to the girls. Secondary causes of osteoporosis: prolonged glucocorticoid therapy, increased bone resorption and reduced bone synthesis, cigarette smoking, excess alcohol can reduce bone mass. Clinical course kya hai? Thoracic and lumbar vertebral fracture are common, leading to loss of height, and various deformities include kyphoscoliosis. It is the deformation of the spine, which can compromise respiratory function. Like, you know, the kyphoscoliosis of the spine disturb over, it also disturb the respiratory function. pulmonary embolism and pneumonia are complication of fracture of femoral leg or spine. Here you can see osteoporosis, genetic factor, influence the peak bone mass, nutrition affects the peak bone mass, physical activity affects the peak bone mass, menopause may have decreased serum estrogen, increase interleukin 1, interleukin 6, tumor necrotic factor level, increase expression of RANK ligand, increase osteoclastic activity. This RANK ligand, as I have told you, it is concerned with the differentiation and activation of osteoclasts. And it and you can see it's compared with aging, decreased replicative activity of osteoporogenitor cells, decreased synthetic activity of osteoblasts, decreased biological activity of matrix bound growth factor, reduced physical activity due to the aging process, it also leads to the osteoporosis. It is the pathophysiology of postmenopausal and senile osteoporosis. Now, diagnosis category. Osteoporosis is difficult to diagnose because it is asymptomatic until skeletal fragility lead to fracture. So most of the time jo hai wo hum diagnose hi nahi kar sakte jab tak ke bahut zyada skeletal deformity ya fracture na ho. Plain radiograph show osteoporosis when 30-40% bone mass is lost. Yani ki initial stages pe it is difficult to diagnose on plain x-ray, plain radiograph. Until the 30-40% bone mass is lost. So how can we diagnose it? We diagnose, currently osteoporosis is detected by specialized radiographic technique to assess bone mineral density. Bone mineral density, the amount of mineral which is present on the bone. Such as, so ye jo hum investigation karenge ya hum imaging karenge, usko kehte hain dual energy absorptiometry and quantitative computed tomography. So the most important diagnostic tool nowadays to detect the osteoporosis as early as possible is the absorptiometry and quantitative computed tomography. Osteoporosis prevention and treatment. Begin with the adequate dietary calcium intake. It is very much necessary to take a good amount of calcium to give a good amount of vitamin D. And regular exercise, as I have told you, physical activity prevents the osteoporosis, early osteoporosis. Or yes, when it comes before the age of 30, to maximize the peak bone mass, and they are used in later life, reduce the bone loss. As I have told you, bone is act as a bank. Anti-resorptive agents such as bisphosphonate, calcitonin, estrogen decrease the bone resorption by osteoclast. Sometimes hormone replacement therapy is given to the women, but hazards of the hormone replacement therapy is there. But sometimes we give patient hormone replacement therapy to prevent the osteoporosis and other factors of the osteoporosis. Main anabolic agent is parathyroid hormone or an analog given to stimulate osteoblastic activity. Sare agent which stimulate the osteoblastic activity is given to the patient to prevent the osteoporosis. So this is our first topic, osteoporosis. Now the second important topic, as you know, and it is the very much important, is the vitamin D deficiency. And as you know, vitamin D deficiency is result from reduced endogenous synthesis due to inadequate exposure to sunlight. As you know, the sunlight is a very good source of vitamin D. So inadequate exposure to sunlight, dietary deficiency of vitamin D, as you know, it is present in the rat meat. If we take the little amount of vitamin D, it also causes the deficiency of vitamin D, and also the malabsorption of lipids due to lack of bile salt. As you know, vitamin D is the lipid-soluble vitamin, so bile salts are very much important for to prevent the vitamin D deficiency. Derangement of vitamin D metabolism has occurred in kidney disorder, liver disorder, and genetic disorder. As you know, the metabolism of the vitamin D is completed in kidney, liver, so it and variety of the enzymes are required for this procedure. So when there is disease of kidney, like chronic kidney failure, or the patient which are in the dialysis, the liver disorder, like the patient who are suffering from any type of the hepatitis, and the genetic disorder, all these can lead to the vitamin D deficiency. And resistance of end organ to respond to vitamin D deficiency or vitamin D result in sometimes the functions of the organs are normal, but they are resistant to vitamin D. This is an other cause of the, and the also the important cause of the vitamin D deficiency. The two most important lesion or the most important diseases which occur due to vitamin D deficiency is the rickets in growing children and osteomalacia in adult. It is seen that when the vitamin D deficiency is occur before the epiphysis is closed, before the growing plate is there, it lead to the rickets. And when it is occur, deficiency is occur in older age, it lead to the osteomalacia. And there is a difference between these two variety of the vitamin D deficiency. Now you can see the what are the important causes. Poor dietary intake, most common in Asian population, reduced synthesis from sun exposure, genetic vitamin D dependent rickets, hypophosphatemia rickets, X-linked dominancy, malabsorption, celiac disease, cystic fibrosis, renal diseases, low 125 dihydroxyvitamin D, the most active form, liver diseases, medications such as anticonvulsant, induced hepatic enzyme, and also the drug which is used to reduce the cholesterol, cholestyramine, and the, also the drug which is used in HIV/AIDS also causes the vitamin D deficiency. Now here you can see the normal vitamin D metabolism when we take ultraviolet radiation, 7D hydroxy, cholesterol in skin, vitamin D in blood, it goes to the liver where the enzyme is present, D25 hydroxylase, it converts the 25 dihydroxy vitamin D, and then the enzyme act alpha 1 hydroxylase, it converts the 25 into the 125 dihydroxy vitamin D. There is increased absorption from small intestine, calcium and phosphorus, normal serum level of calcium and phosphorus, phosphate, there is an increased bone mineralization by calcium and phosphate. Now, when the vitamin D deficiency, the enzymes are not present, so 125 is not changed into the 25, calcium and phosphate ki absorption reduce ho jayegi, serum calcium and phosphate decrease ho jayegi, and there is an activation of parathyroid hormones. And parathyroid hormone causes the, to maintain the calcium level, it causes the resorption of bone and removes the calcium from the bone. So to maintain the serum calcium level, and this phosphate is removed from the urine and calcium remain in the blood. So because of the demineralization is taking place, so vitamin D is very much important for the calcium absorption. As you know, the vitamin D, the calcitol is the enzyme which is required for the calcium absorption. It is produced by the vitamin D. So vitamin D is very much important for calcium absorption. Now, what is rickets? Rickets' primary defect in rickets are interference with mineralization of bone, deranged and chondral and intramembranous bone growth. Morphological feature, rickets occur in growing children from 6 to 2 years old. Mostly before the growing plate is mostly closed, it occurs before this. So skeletal changes, craniotips. These the defect or the skeletal deformities of the chest and the head is mostly occur in those children which are immobilized and which are not moving. So the first important change is the craniotaps, small round unossified area in the membranous bone of the skull, disappearing within 12 months of birth. Skull look square and box like, yani ke this spherical shape hota hai, wo nahi hota, square or box like hota hai. It is called as craniotaps. Other hai Harrison sulcus. due to indrawing of the soft rib on inspiration. Another is the rachitic rosin, deformity of chest due to party laziness, overgrowth at postural junction, and we feel the bead-like appearance beneath the skin. So rachitic means the beading of the Catholic Christians. Rachitic means rachitic rosary, and it's a beaded appearance of this ribs. It is called rachitic rosary. Pigeon chest is the anterior protrusion of the sternum due to action of respiratory muscle. Because they are become soft fragile due to the respiration, the chest is like become pigeon, protruded anteriorly. Bow legs occur in ambulatory children. Ab do, jo the chest or skull deformities thi mostly occur in non-ambulatory children. Jo bachche abhi chote hain. Aur jo ab legs ki aur spine ki, it is mostly occur in ambulatory children. Bow legs occur in ambulatory children due to weak bone of lower leg, knock knee, occur due to enlarged end of the femur, tibia, and fibula. Lower epiphysis of radius may be enlarged. Lumbar lordosis means there is a deformity of the lumbar spine. Is due to the involvement of spine and pelvis. Biochemical changes, lower level of active metabolite of vitamin D, 25 hydroxy vitamin D, and 1.25 dihydroxy vitamin D. Plasma calcium level are normal or slightly low. Plasma phosphate level are low because it is excreted in urine. Plasma alkaline phosphatase is usually raised due to osteoblastic activity. Osteoblastic activity is present, but mineralization of the bone is not taking place. Treatment kya hai? Disease respond rapidly to the administration of active form of vitamin D, 125 dihydroxy vitamin D. When you give to the patient, it rapidly respond to the respond to the treatment and give a good result. Mostly, the difference between the rickets and osteomalacia in the ricket, because it mostly occurs before the epiphysis is closed, so there is a deformity. There is a skeletal contour is changed in children, but in osteomalacia mostly occur in older age. So contour of the bone, the shape of the bone is not changed, but it is easily it becomes fragile and sometimes there is a bending of the bone is there. Now here you can see effect of rickets, short stature, oat shaped skull, jisko humne bataya, craniotaps, pigeon chest, spine deformities ho sakti hain, oat shaped ribs hain, pelvic deformity, vivid knee joint, knock knee, ankle joint deform, bow legs, wide wrist joint, wide elbow joint. So you can see the changes in the baby up, and this rickets is occur mostly up to the age of 2 years. Craniotaps, Harrison sulcus, pigeon chest, all these deformities, knock knee, all these are present in rickets children. Now the second is also the bone loss, but it occur in older age. Morphological features due to deficiency of vitamin D, osteoid matrix let down, failed to get mineralized. वही फर्क दोनों में यही है, mineralize उसमें भी नहीं हो रहा, mineralize इसमें भी नहीं हो रहा, लेकिन वो अगर mostly अगर in the children up to the 2 years of the age, it occur in the older age. Widened and thickened osteoid, decreased mineralization at the border between osteoid and bone. There may be increased osteoclastic activity and fibrosis of marrow, bone marrow. Clinical feature, osteomalacia is characterized by muscular weakness, vague bony pain, fracture, swollen, trivial trauma. Small trauma ke upar bhi fracture ho jayega. Incomplete or green stick fracture. Incomplete or green stick yani ke fracture jo hai zyadatar bachcho mein hota hai. Loser zone or pseudo fracture at weak places in the bone. Loser zones kya hote hain ke white area ya white line of the translucent area or which look like fracture, but it is not actually the fracture. And loser, why it is called loser? Loser is the name of scientist which discover this or which first experience this type of the fracture. So the name is given loser zone or pseudo fracture or milkman syndrome bhi kehte hain. Isme abhi main aapko dikhaungi the next slide. You can see the a line or the wide band of the white band of the translucent area at right angle to the cortex of the bone. which is called the loser zone or milkman syndrome or pseudoephrectic. Biochemical changes, normal or low serum calcium level, plasma phosphate level is low, raised serum alkaline phosphate is due to increased osteoblastic activity. Osteoblastic activity normal है, लेकिन vitamin D की वजह से mineralization of the bone is not taking place. Now here you can see normal bone, osteoporotic bone, osteomalacate. Osteoporotic bone is thin and brittle because there is too little of it, although the composition of the bone is normal. Osteomalacia, the total mass of bone may be normal, but it is soft and weak because it is not properly mineralized. In children, osteomalacia is non-existent, as I have told you. So this is the difference between the normal bone, osteoporotic bone, and osteomalacia. Now here you can see it is shown by an arrow that a line is present. It is the white zone of the translucent area, and this look like fracture when we see with the radiograph or the plain X-ray, but it is not a original fracture. It is called the loser zone or the pseudo fracture. So it is today we end our lecture. Thank you. Hi, hold on.
वो चैनल आप देख
अगर आपको कोई क्वेश्चन पूछना है आप पूछ सकते हो बेटा कोई क्वेश्चन हो एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क बेटा एनी
कैलेंडर लो
दो टाइप के बोन्स और भी होती हैं, वुवेन बोन और लैमिनर बोन. वुवेन बोन जो होते हैं चिल्ड्रन में होते हैं, एंड दिस वुवेन बोन इज व्हिच कंटेन मोर ऑस्टियोसाइट, एंड दिस वुवेन बोन इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय लैमिनर बोन व्हिच कंटेन लेस ऑस्टियोसाइट. ये भी एक टाइप से बोन थी, वुवेन एंड लैमिनर बोन. एनी क्वेश्चन बेटा? And I have told you that a list of the causes of osteoporosis, and you can see in your books the list of causes. The any question? Any question? Is there any question you can ask? Beta, any question? बेटा एक्सक्यूज मी कोई क्वेश्चन हो तो आप पूछ सकते हो. एनी क्वेश्चन? एनी क्वेश्चन? एनी क्वेश्चन बेटा? थैंक यू.
और आज हम जो है आज ध्यान कर पढ़ दी ना और बहुत बहुत